Welcome to the first of two videos that will focus on the ellipse. The goal of this video is to graph an ellipse in standard form. An ellipse is a set of all points x, y, the sum whose distances from two fixed points called the foci is constant. This animation is the best illustration of the definition of an ellipse. If we pick any point on an ellipse and construct a segment to each foci, as we see here in blue and red, the sum of those two lengths is always constant. As we see here, the sum of those lengths is always equal to 10, regardless of the point on the ellipse. Now, if we have the standard form of an ellipse, we can gather a lot of information about the graph. The standard form of the equation of ellipse will have center hk, and the major axis will have length 2a, and the minor axis will have length 2b. So what that means is, if the ellipse is in this form, we can identify the center of the ellipse very similar to how we did for the circle. Next, the major axis is the longer of the two axes. So if the major axis has length 2a, this distance here would be a, and so would this. And the same is true if we have a vertical major axis. This would be length a, and this would be length a. Next, the shorter of the two axes, or the minor axis, will have length 2b. Therefore, if we cut it in half, we'll have length b and length b here, as well as over here. One of the most important things we have to be able to identify is whether the major axis is horizontal, as we see here, or vertical, as we see here. And that's based upon that a is always greater than b. So if you take a look at this first equation in standard form, a squared is going to be the larger denominator. So if the larger denominator is under the x part, just think the x-axis is a horizontal axis, so this ellipse will have a horizontal major axis. If the larger denominator is under the y part, just think the y-axis is the vertical axis, therefore the major axis will be vertical in this case. So the largest denominator will be a squared, and the smaller denominator will be b squared. Now, there's one other key component about an ellipse that we need to be able to find, and that is the foci. Let's first take a look at it when we have a horizontal major axis. The foci lie on the major axis c units from the center, with a squared equal to b squared plus c squared. Now, this should kind of remind you of the Pythagorean theorem, but now what we have to remember is that a is the largest of the three, therefore a squared will be on one side of the equal sign by itself. So we can calculate c, and once we have it, we can use it to determine the two foci as we see here in blue. If the major axis is horizontal, and this distance here is c and c, then the coordinates of this point would be h plus c, comma k, and the coordinates of this point would be h minus c, comma k. So if it has a horizontal major axis, we'll add or subtract c from the x-coordinate. However, if we have a vertical major axis, again, this is c and this is c, we would have to then add or subtract c from the y-coordinate of the center to determine the two foci. So this would now be h, k plus c, and this would be h, k minus c. Let's first determine whether this is going to be a vertical or horizontal major axis. Remember, that's determined by the larger denominator. Since the larger denominator is under the y part, we are going to have a vertical major axis. So from that, we should be able to determine that a squared is equal to 9, therefore a equals 3, and b squared must equal 4, therefore b equals 2. Next, we should also be able to determine the center, because the center is hk. So in this form, if we see x minus 3, the x-coordinate would be positive 3, and if we see y plus 1, the y-coordinate would be negative 1. So from this information, we should be able to graph a nice ellipse. Let's try. The center is 3, negative 1. The major axis is vertical, and since a is equal to 3, from here we'll go up 3 units, and down 3 units. That's our major axis with length 2a, or 6. The minor axis has length 2b, and since b is 2, from the center we can go right 2 units and left 2 units. and the ellipse must pass through these 4 points. Let's go ahead and sketch it. Now it looks very circular, but notice we went up and down 3 and left and right 2, so it's not a circle. Now the last thing you're usually asked to find are the 2 foci. Now remember, this is the center HK and this is the major axis, so we need to find the value of C and add and subtract it to the Y coordinate of the center. Remember, A is the largest of the 3, so the formula to find C would be A squared equals B squared plus C squared. Well, we know A squared is 9, and we know B squared is 4. So we have C squared equals 5. So C would equal the square root of 5. Since C is equal to the square root of 5, and we have a vertical major axis, we're going to add and subtract the square root of 5 to our Y coordinate. Let's go ahead and do that on the next screen, and then we'll come back and plot those points. The center was 3, negative 1, and C is equal to the square root of 5. Since we have a vertical major axis, the foci will be 3 and then negative 1 plus or minus the square root of 5. So one foci will be 3 and then negative 1 plus the square root of 5, and then the second foci will be 3, negative 1 minus the square root of 5. Let's go ahead and find the decimal approximations for this. So this is approximately, let's say, 1.24. And the second foci would be negative 1 minus square root 5. So negative 3.24. Let's go ahead and plot those on the previous graph. We had 3, 1.24 somewhere here. And then we had 3, and the other foci was 3, negative 3.24. Let's see if we have time for one more. Okay, so this equation is in standard form, but it looks a little funny because the y part does not have a denominator, but we can just go ahead and put this over 1. Notice the larger denominator is under the x part, therefore now we have a horizontal major axis. We can also conclude that a squared equals 9 and b squared equals 1. Well, that tells us that a equals 3 and b equals 1. Next, we should be able to determine the center. If it's x plus 2, the x coordinate would be negative 2. And if it's y minus 1, the y coordinate would be positive 1. This is actually enough information to make a nice graph, though we still have to go back and find the foci. Let's graph our center, negative 2, 1. The major axis is horizontal, and a is equal to 3, so we'll go right 3 units and left 3 units. Notice our major axis would be 6 units. Next, since b is equal to 1, we'll go up 1 unit and down 1 unit. Our ellipse will pass through these 4 points. Let's go ahead and sketch it. Remember, the foci will be on the major axis, so now we're going to have to find c and add and subtract it to the x-coordinate of the center. Let's go ahead and label this negative 2, 1. Remember, for an ellipse, we have a squared equals b squared plus c squared. So we know a squared is 9. We know b squared is 1. And this allows us to find c. Subtracting 1 from both sides, we'd have 8 equals c squared. Take the principal square root of both sides. So we have c equals square root of 8, which is 2 square root 2. So we're going to take this value and add and subtract it to the x-coordinate of the center. Let's go ahead and do that on the next screen. Again, let's go ahead and convert these to decimal approximations so it makes it easier for us to graph. So let's go ahead and go back to our graph and plot these 2 foci. Negative 0.831, and the other focus is negative 4.83, 1. Okay, I think that'll do it for this video. We'll go ahead and review the major components of the ellipse again in the next video, and then show how to graph an ellipse when it's given in general form. Thank you for watching.